At any one moment in time, there's over 10 million people in prison throughout the world, of whom about a third are awaiting trial or sentence. Penal Reform International is an international, independent, non-governmental organisation that promotes fair and effective solutions to criminal justice problems worldwide. Since 1989, we have focused very much on trying to reduce the unnecessary use of imprisonment and making sure that only people who commit serious or violent offences should spend time in prison.
Too much emphasis has been made on decongesting prisons without looking at the causes. The real causes are that the inflow is too high, and not everybody who gets into prison deserves to be there in the first place, whether as a remand prisoner or a convicted prisoner.
One of the reasons why people spend such a long time in pre-trial detention is because of the inefficiency of the court procedures. And therefore we work with governments and also with community organisations and local NGOs to try and help people to represent themselves at trial. One of the most important ways of doing this is through what's called a paralegal system. This is where you have non-lawyers who are trained to help people to represent themselves and to understand the court process.
I work as a paralegal. I'm here to interview you. So whatever you tell me, please tell me the truth.
One of the most successful paralegal projects was in Malawi with the Paralegal Advisory Service. The Malawi model uses a mixture of role play, education, games, and teaching so that the prisoners learn what they need to do when they go to court, what the procedure will be.
Through their paralegal aid clinics, one paralegal can reach over 100 prisoners. The impact of paralegals has been immediate and impressive.
The second main way that we try and reduce overcrowding in prison is by promoting and developing alternative sanctions. There is increasing evidence that people reoffend less if they're given a community-based sanction rather than a sentence of imprisonment.
It responds directly to the challenge of overcrowding in the prisons. It's less expensive to government and it pulls the community into the rehabilitation of prisoners.
For example, they may be asked to go and help repair some building or decorate a school or help clean a hospital. And when this is successful, it's a benefit to themselves, their families and their communities. Currently, we are working in Tanzania, Uganda and Kenya. So little by little, the word is getting out that these things work. And so progress is being made over time to reduce the rate of overcrowding in prisons and also to help people to understand there are many other ways of dealing with offenders rather than locking them up.
Young.